Do you want to have your music placed in TV shows that will reach millions? Well, here's how we did it. Getting your music placed in a TV show means reaching millions. It means getting a new audience, which was never before possible. It also means a pretty good paycheck coming your way. But how do you go about actually getting your music placed in TV shows? Because it's not often that you actually hear of artists bragging about this. You hear of artists getting placed in Spotify playlists, into blogs, in radio stations as well, but not very often on TV. But it is a lot easier than you think. We've had artists placed in TV shows which have meant it's reached over 3.5 million people. And I'm going to explain more about that right at the end. I'm going to actually give you an example of an artist that we pitched to national TV and had them placed in a show which reached millions. And we did it all ourselves, so we can explain to you how we did it. And you can do the exact same thing. So stick around to the end to make sure you hear our story on how we did it, because if you follow those tips, then it could be you too. So before I get into how you actually do get your track placed in TV, let's discuss the benefits, because there's a long list of them. And then I'll tell you all about how you find the right person, how you send your music to them, how to make sure that it's actually going to be listened to and potentially used. I do know that you can actually get a licensing agent to do it for you, but not all of you are going to have that sort of money. So I'm going to discuss this from the perspective of just pitching as an artist to the right people, and I'm only going to be discussing TV. If you want to hear more about, say, films, video games, YouTube videos, any of those, make sure to let me know in the comments. The name for all of those things, getting your track placed in TV, films, video games, YouTube videos, is Music Sync Licensing. Ignore the fancy name, you don't need to use that at all, you don't have to think about it, but that is the term, and it means getting your track placed in those areas, and in exchange, getting money. You can get paid to write a piece specifically for something like a commercial, but in this situation, we're going to be talking specifically about getting your track placed in TV, which means collecting royalties from every time it's played. I know there can be different situations, like they can pay an upfront fee to a label, but in this situation, we're just talking about the simple things, which is usually collecting royalties. But I guess this is jumping right to the end. How do you actually get to those people? How do you actually get your track placed? Well, you need to make sure that first of all, you're reaching the right person. And that person is a music supervisor. The job of a music supervisor is to source music and then place it in the show. They decide when music is needed. They decide what track actually suits that moment in time. They usually use music which is already in their existing catalog. So that can be created from previous TV shows they've had, from music publishers, from artists themselves, from songwriters, from labels, from management, and they'll already have that existing catalog. And for them, it can be quite simple to just take tracks out of that. They've already signed agreements with them, so they just place them in. However, on TV shows where there can be specific moments where certain lyrics, specific tempos work, having new music submitted to them can be essential. It can change the TV show entirely. So there is an opportunity there. There is a chance for artists, for you, to pitch your music to music supervisors and be placed in TV shows. So essentially, the music supervisor is a gatekeeper. They're the one that takes it to the end production team. They take the track and say, this is fitting for this moment. So they're the one that you want to reach. They're the one that you need to email and make sure that that email is opened. But before doing any of that, you need to make sure your track is actually registered. The reason that you need to actually register that song is because if they accept it, they need to pay you. They need to make sure that they're paying the payments to the correct people. So this means going through PRS, PPL, because they'll often ask for the PRS tune code and the PPL ISRC. Don't wait until they've actually accepted the track, because then you might actually lose that opportunity, especially if it's a series where they're literally creating the actual episode and providing the music within days of each other. If you're looking at things like I'm a Celeb, Love Island, they're placing that track 24 hours before because they need to get a new episode out every single day. So now you've got the track registered and you know you need to be sending it to a music supervisor. How do you find the music supervisor? Well, you can do a simple thing like a LinkedIn search. You can even do a simple Google search. You can literally Google search a lot of TV shows and then write the word music supervisor and that person will come up. They'll come up through the social media, through LinkedIn, through an article, because a lot of them do open interviews as well. But if that's quite difficult to do, you can do a little bit of stalking on something like Twitter, because often they'll put the username of the TV show, the handle itself, in their bio. So you can search that and then search by people and they might come up. Often, music supervisors also speak on panels, so if you find that they're at a panel near you, definitely attend. You'll be able to understand more about what they do, what they look for, so when you do finally contact them, it's a lot more personal. I wouldn't suggest going straight up to them and handing a CD because they get that way too often. A lot of industry professionals have shoved CDs down their throat and it's just not what you want. They definitely prefer digitals because if you have your digital correctly done, it will have the metadata in it that they need. So have a polite conversation with them, explain what you do, explain how you might be of interest to them, and say personal things so that when you go to message them the next day, they actually remember you. Don't make it all about you. Make it about the conversation you're having. Just make it real. They're a lot more likely to engage with someone and potentially place a track if they like the person behind the song. So now you've got that music supervisor in mind that you want to target. You need to write the right email to them. They do receive a lot of emails, so you need to make yourself stand out. And the best way to do this is to make sure it's actually personalized to the music supervisor, to the show. So you start every email with hi and their name, so they know it's not a copy and paste. And then you can say something along the lines of, I feel like my track is perfect for insert show name, and then explain why. Explain how the tempo, the lyrics, the mood is fitting to them. The mood is really helpful because often their catalog is put into either tempos or moods. So if they do like your song and you've given them the mood up front, they'll be able to place it in the catalog in the right place. You can also add a little bit of credibility in that email so they know you're worth listening to. So that could be previous press, previous sync, previous radio play, even playlisting that you've had. That credibility means that they're a lot more likely to listen to the song. It also helps if you know the show very well. What I'm going to explain in the end is how we got a track placed in national TV. And the reason that this happened is because I knew the show that we pitched to so well that I knew that the track was fitting for certain scenes. So they knew it wasn't a copy and paste job. If you're still really struggling to find a music supervisor or a TV show that's fitting to your music, there are listings online. And these listings outline what sort of music they're looking for the show, the commercial, the movie. And what I'll do is I'll link below a few websites, and there's actually an app in there as well, which means that you can actually find these listings. Some of them you do have to pay. And if you don't have the money, then hopefully the rest of the video means that you can do it yourself. But if you do have that bit of a budget, it can be worth giving a go. Especially if you get a really good deal, you get paid tens of thousands of pounds for something like a commercial, then that money that you invested in that doesn't really matter anymore. You've made that money back. Now onto how we did it. We've had tracks placed on national TV before. We secured ITV This Morning, which I've done a full video on, and I'll make sure to link that one below. That opportunity got an artist signed to a major booking agency, so that's definitely worth checking out. We also got a track played on Love Island, which has 3.7 million viewers on each episode. But the one I'm going to be talking about is when we got an artist placed in Made in Chelsea. For those of you that live outside of the UK, you may not know of Made in Chelsea, but it's a reality TV show, basically just about a load of people that live in Chelsea, London. I absolutely love the show, so when we got the track placed, I was pretty excited. The show goes out to nearly a million people each episode, so we knew it was an amazing opportunity. Not often do we take a track and pitch it to national TV because the artist has to have the right song that's perfect for the show. And if we pitch the wrong music to the music supervisor, that contact that we've built will just be broken down. So this was a perfect situation. We worked with the indie rock band Orchid Collective. Within these campaigns, we secured 5 Spotify playlists, including New Music Friday, Alternative Generation, Feel Good Indie, press coverage in the likes of Clash, Red Bull, Flavour Mag, and also a BBC Radio 6 play. So the band were doing really well. We knew that their campaign was successful, but we wanted to take that step further. So within the pitch, I used all the credibility that we already secured, so the BBC Radio 6 play, Clash premiere, the Spotify playlist, all of that, put it into the pitch, but also outlined a scenario where if they did place the track, it would fit perfectly. Having that personal email, but also having that credibility, meant that they got placed. Not only does this mean that their track reached nearly a million people, but it also acts as credibility even further. Imagine you want to go into a label meeting where you want to go meet a potential manager, a booking agent, say. If you say, I've been played on national TV, I've been played on Made in Chelsea, which if you say in the UK, everyone knows, then you've got that credibility. It's a fantastic platform to be on. So that's how we did it, and that's exactly how you can do it too. I included a case study in this one because I did so in a previous video and the comments said that you liked it. And if you did, please let me know. And if you don't, also let me know so I can take the feedback and stop doing them. But with the case studies, I feel like it adds a little bit more legitimacy to the tutorials, but also shows how we do it every day and just how you can do it easily. I hope you found this video useful. And if you did, make sure to hit that like button. And if you haven't joined the community yet, make sure to hit subscribe, turn on that bell so you're notified when we upload. And we'll be back soon with more music marketing advice.